I don't even need this.
Are you serious?
Train going by. Always, always, always.
Ecotones are everywhere. An ecotone is an ecological gradient. It's a change in the local composition of plants and animals across space. These can either be super sharp boundaries like a tree line, or they can be massive regions where two ecosystems mix and blend into each other. Why does this happen? What causes these ecotones to form in the first place? And how big or small can they get? The word ecotone was definitely, maybe coined by Alfred Russel Wallace in 1859. It comes from the roots eco, like ecosystem, and tonos, meaning tension. It's a region where two ecosystems meet and are in tension, a transition zone where there's a shift in dominance from one group of species to another. One of the largest ecotones on Earth is between the Sahara Desert and the rainforest on the African continent. Another is the slow shift across the US from temperate forest to grassland to desert. At this scale, you're talking about transitions between entire biomes. Biomes are the largest definable ecological zones. There are also smaller zones within biomes, like ecoregions and ecozones. What matters is that these ecological regions occur at a really wide range of scales. If you're ever in the US and you drive from Phoenix to Flagstaff, Arizona, you start off in the Sonoran Desert, and then as you go up in elevation, you pass through these expansive grasslands onto the juniper forest, and then finally the ponderosa pine forest. That's all within 2 hours. There are ecotones in the ocean too. The ocean is divided into these segments based on depth: the mesopelagic, the bathypelagic, the abyssopelagic. That one does not sound fun. Each of these segments supports radically different flora and fauna. The mixing zones between them are ecotones. Something eerily reminiscent of ecotones can even exist on a single rock. This zonation has formed. These different zones spend a different amount of time underwater on average. What's common to all these situations? What's causing these ecotones to form? The first thing is microclimates. What happens as you go deeper into the ocean? It's getting darker, it's getting colder, the pressure is increasing, the salinity is changing, even the oxygen concentration is changing. These are called ecoclines, changes in the physical and chemical properties of the environment over space. These ecoclines create a really diverse set of microclimates. What happens over evolutionary time, organisms will evolve to thrive in each of these microclimates. They'll generally stay within their preferred microclimate because that's just best for their survival. On land, we usually see ecotones as changes in plant density. Part of the reason is the microclimate is changing. But there's another reason this ecotone has formed, and that is the local competition between species. Water is a little scarce in a desert, and plants are always competing for space and resources. We just don't see it because that competition plays out over a really large time scale. In the end, only the plants that are most suited for a particular microclimate can dominate in that region. Ecotones are extremely widespread. You don't have to look very far to find them. Just go outside, go exploring, and observe the landscape. You can imagine going outside, or just watch a video of people exploring. Bye.